For me, I want to highlight that you remind me a lot of myself, and that you are passionate about your education. You know that it's a path to something bigger than you and your family. It is what you need to do to be you, and that's really strong. Because you remind me so much of me, I also want to remind you that it is not that you are not creative. It is, you are very creative. And we had this conversation, we talked about how math takes creativity. It is, and you have to get out of that idea. You can't keep saying, I am not this, I am not that, because I am not this about one thing turns into I am not this about other things whenever you experience failure. And so you want to get into the habit of saying, I could have spent 2 weeks on this and really thought about how can I make it look nicer. And creativity comes from, if you can recognize what something looks like, if it's creative, then you just gotta get there. Like, you know what creative looks like, you know that's not creative. So get to what is creative. So don't give up.
Yeah, I think part of that, what he's saying is, don't sell yourself short. Believe that you can do whatever you set your mind to. You've got this panel convinced that you can do whatever you put in your head. And creativity is part of that. You can be creative. Even though you're not an artist, maybe you're not a musician and you're not those things, but creativity comes from within. All you have to do is find the expression and express it.
I loved how you take your education and you're using it. And not only that, you're thinking of other courses that you're going to take that are going to help you improve yourself. I mean, that's just everything that we want, for sure, as educators. That's what we're here for, and we're hoping that you guys do that, and we love that. I was just going to say the one thing that I would just caution you, just make sure that you don't let your side job bog you down.
Oh yeah, my mom's so worried.
Okay, good, yeah, because I want you back in sports and back in extracurricular activities, yes. Like, as soon as possible.
No, yeah, I'm in county. Okay, so I'm going to tell you something. I planned a wedding for my parents, 25th anniversary, and I'm paying for it. Well, me and my brother and my sister. So I was like, I have to get a job. I know it's going to be really hard. I got the job. And now every paycheck goes for the wedding. But after that,
now
wedding,
we know why
after
you're
the
working.
Wedding, I'm not working.
That's incredible. I was mind blown by how incredible this was. I was telling her, I just met you a few weeks ago, and when you were like, oh, can I work on my defense stuff? I was like, man, is she procrastinating? Like, come on. And then I saw this, and I was like, she was not procrastinating. She was perfecting it, like, all first period today. She was practicing with the girls and running through it, wanting to be perfect. But you can just tell you love learning. You can tell that you reflect on everything well. You know your strengths and your weaknesses, and you know, like, what you're going to do to combat those weaknesses and do better. That was incredible. I even wrote down what the quote she said.
My one strength that I just wanted to throw out there, I love your presence as you stand. The way you hold your body is great. The way even you hold
you
your hand. Do I do this?
No. Ms. Gristle is really energetic. She will make love for 1 hour and 30 minutes.
That's why I liked it. And I also,
it's like looking in the mirror.
As it is. And I also, I mean, just little subtleties about your presentation skills, like doing this. You turned and you pointed and you used your arms, and it makes it better for us when we sit through so many to see a little variation. And I really liked that part of your presentation skill. That was my favorite strength. Okay.
Yeah, just I really enjoyed the confidence that you were able to demonstrate this evening. I know we asked you some tough questions, and sometimes when you work on a project and you know you have to defend, you have to kind of work through it a little bit and look at it from the macro. So, you know, go up a few levels and think, hey, what kind of questions will a panel like this ask you? You know, like on your next interview for the mayor's team, think about those questions. What questions may someone ask you, and will you be ready to respond to those questions? So really enjoyed your presentation, and I think you came across as being very, very confident. So thank you.
Thank you.
All right, Leslie, so I have good news for you. You have passed. passed with distinction, and it, you passed so well that it's even pink to match.
Oh, to match your purse.
Now you can skip the line at lunch, you can go straight to the front, except the senior line, don't skip the senior line, they get mad.
Okay. And we've got to take a photo of you.
Yeah. Parents?
Yes, parents.